Good afternoon, one and all. In morning only, we would have started our lecture. Unfortunately, it was not happened. I was ready with the system, but sometimes situation is not in our hand. Because of some technical error, I was not able to reach up to you. Extremely sorry for that. Now I am recording the today's session, and I will drop that lecture on YouTube and I will send you that link on our channel also. Today we are going to discuss about georeferencing topo sheet in QGIS. Before that, we are going to discuss about some points. In that, very important thing is that I want to discuss one point, that is a software installation problem. I have received many messages from the participant. They are facing some problems while installing software. First we will discuss, we will have some little discuss on that. Then we will go regarding homework. You people are doing very nice job. Many participants, they are contact me on WhatsApp, mail, on call also. They are sending me their feedback, their work, what you people are doing, your home. I want to say some your results also. Then after we'll go some queries. Some people are to ask me some problems. We'll discuss we'll have one discuss on that, and then we'll go to the georeferencing. The first thing is that many people, they face this problem while installing the QGIS software. Some people are getting this kind of problem with them. I want to share one thing. When we are installing QGIS 3.10, that time our system, it should be the operating system, it should be greater than 8.1 operating system, means Windows 10 and like that. Those are using Windows 7, they are facing such kind of problem. For those people who is using Windows 7, for them I would recommend, please go with the old version 2.618 like that of QGIS. That setup is suitable for the Windows 7. Rest of the people, they can use current version or newer version, those means 10.3.10, 3.12 also they can save in your system. I want to just use this mic. For that I am using this headphone, otherwise there is no any other purpose of this system. Okay, now here I want to discuss about some homework. Some participant, they send me their output. This kind of work people are doing their home. It is very nice job, very sincerely and seriously you people are doing your work at home. You always do ask me query as per my capacity. I am trying to explain your queries on call, message, text, WhatsApp, and sometime email also. These are the some example screens which participant had shared with me. I thought this should be shared with you people, means those who are newly joined to our course, they also will see what kind of work till now we had done. Now these queries I have received from the participant. The first thing, that is the in yesterday's lecture we have gone through the projected coordinate system and geographic coordinate system. One participant asked me which kind of coordinate system is suitable or more useful, either projected or geographic. Both the system, coordinate system, having their own importance and their own necessity. But I would recommend here, when we are using any plane surface like a topo sheet, cadastral map, small area map, any kind of map, that time we have to go with the projected coordinate system. The next question is related to the Z ordering. Already I have discussed on that what is the Z ordering. Here the question is related to the raster map. Our concern is that whenever we are using any data set, either vector data set or raster data set, that time it should be all layer, it should be the visible. Means in last lecture only I have given that example. Suppose we mount the point line polygon layer on the top of the point and line, then all the point features and line features will be covered under the polygon. That time you should maintain that hierarchy: first point, then line, and then polygon. Suppose in between you have some raster data also, and you have to use that raster data. That time what can we do? We can maintain that hierarchy: point, line. Suppose our raster data is smaller than that polygon, means just like at look at here. Suppose this is our raster data, our satellite image, and rest of the area is polygon. Then surely we can give the hierarchy: point, line, then raster image in between that, and after that the polygon. Then it will be a suitable for the hierarchy. Otherwise, what will happen? Suppose we maintain that hierarchy: point, line, polygon. After that, suppose we kept that our satellite image, then that satellite image, it is not visible. That's why we have to keep that raster data after the line, and then your last that polygon. Then it will be a suitable for your understanding. Another one thing we can do, suppose we have maintained like that: point, line, last one polygon, and after that your satellite image or your any kind of topo sheet and like that. Then what we have to do when we are doing that polygon, that time we have to maintain that polygon in a such a way, in a transparent manner. Means we should able to, that user or that researcher, it should be able to see the satellite image. Then it will be easy to understanding and further work. I think though the people who have asked me this query, they have got their answer. And the last one, that is the one of our researcher, he sent me their output. In that, just now I have gone through and I just see what is the actual scenario. The thing is that in the data set we have I have given you the two kind of images. One is the geographic coordinate system, another one the projected coordinate system. Then in a case you have my interest is that we have to just change the coordinate system. Means here you there is no need to use this kind of image. You just go with this geographic image, and we have to just change into the projected coordinate system. That the interest of that question is that one only. We have to just change the another image which is having the geographic coordinate system to the projected coordinate system. Already the participant who sent me this question, already personally I have sent him that answer and that explanation what is actually that. But I want to just share that queries with all the people who is also participating on our workshop. All should get this kind of things. Means people can think in different manner, and we have to find out the solution in a such a way. Because now we are here just discussing on the our conceptual part, but when you people are going to do actual your work, that time it may become different kinds of question, different kinds of problem. That time we have to think in a different way and a different manner. That will be a very useful for the giving the solution. Okay. Now we are coming to the our next thing, that is the georeferencing a topo sheet. This is very important part. And till now we have gone through what is the vector raster, how to open vector data, raster data. Now here we have to see how to georeference the topo sheet. I'm just closing this PPT and opening the software. Here we are going to discuss about the how to georeference the topo sheet. Before going to do the practical, before that we should know what is the georeferencing. Georeferencing is nothing but that I will give you one very simple example. Suppose I have this paper with me, and this when we are using this paper, and I suppose I draw one city diagram on this paper. Suppose I draw Pune city diagram on this paper. That time what will happen? Just 1 minute. I'm just checking. Suppose we have this paper, and on that paper I draw city diagram, Pune city diagram. But that diagram, that map is not with reference to the earth. Okay, this is just simple paper. Then what we have to do? We have to give the reference of the our earth. That time it will be a some meaningful document. Okay, that name georeference itself, it is giving the information. What does it mean? Okay, means we are giving the reference of the earth to that paper, then it will be a meaningful. Now here we are going to open our data. Already I have given you the data with link yesterday only, and now I hope you are ready with the data set. Okay, whenever we are starting our lecture, before that I am always do give you the data set, and you always be ready with the data set. Then it will be easy when I am talking with you people. That time you simultaneously you can do your work on your system, and afterwards suppose you didn't get exactly what I want to say, that time you can use to see this video again. That all videos are uploaded on the YouTube, on our channel Ravindra Mede. The channel name is Ravindra Mede. You can do visit on that channel, you can see again and again, and you can do the practice. And suppose if you are not able to do your task, then also then you can directly contact to me. Okay, now here I am going to open the data set. Already I told you how to open. First go layer, then add layer, then raster layer. Now here I want to say, till yesterday I was using the another software for the this screening, that is the OBS software. Now here that was I feel some problem in that software. Actually we are missing some drop down menu and like that, and that will be a not good when we are discussing on the distance mode. Everything is the clear and visible. Then I switch to another software, that is the Camtasia, and I am using Camtasia to screen the what I am doing, going to do here. Then it will be easy for your understanding. Now see here, layer, add raster layer. I click here, then you know here raster, this is the browse button. You have to click here, then a new window will open. Then we have to go where our data is saved, or where we have kept that one. Now our data is practical 3 data, third practical. I'm just open, I want to open this topo sheet. Okay, I'm just opening this topo sheet, add and close. What happened here? That topo sheet has opened. Okay, now we can see this topo sheet is here. Now what we have to go, what things we are going to do? We are going to do georeference. For your showing purposes I just open here. But when we are going to do georeferencing in the QGIS, that time it not required to open our topo sheet on the screen. There is another one step, we have to go to there and we have to open our topo sheet there. Okay, then what is that? We have to first go to raster. Okay, in the raster georeferencer is there. Now you go to your raster option, just click there on the raster and find out where is that georeferencer. You are not getting that option. Okay, then why you are not getting that option? Okay, that is not present there or available there. Then what we have to do? We have to just switch here in plugins. Already you just remember the previous lecture, don't forget that. And those people you newly joined to our workshop, they please go to the, our previous lectures from day one, and one by one you just watch all the videos, all the our workshop sessions, and then you will understand what actually I am going to do here. Okay, I am just now here plugin, and in the plugin manage and install the plugins. Okay, you have to just click here. When we will click here, then new window will appear there. Okay, here we have to go first all. Okay, when you will go all, might be you will not get georeferencer there, then just do georefe like that. Automatically that option will be there. This option now like that in uncheck in your system, because newly you are using the QGIS. But here in my case already I have work on there, that's why it is checking there. Then I am just clicking here again and I do close. Now just go to your raster and check out either georeferencer is there or not. Sure, it will be there, you will get that one. Okay, just go here georeferencer. When we will go there, that time this new window will appear. Okay, there will be a two part, this one georeferencer and GCB table next one. See, the way we are using our main display, that time there are also some options, and same way here are also some options. Okay, the first one file, edit, view and setting. Now we are going to one by one what are their options. In the file reset georeferencer, open raster, start georeferencing, generate a GDAL script, load GCP point and save GCP points as. Okay, that options are there. Then in edit, add points, delete point and move point, GCP. What is that GCP? GCP is nothing but that is the ground control points. Okay, now next we are going to see what is that ground control points. Okay, our next view. In view, now you are familiar with the pan button, what is that, and zoom in, zoom out, layer, zoom to layer means full zoom, zoom last, zoom next, all options are familiar. Now setting, transformation setting. Now we are going to use that transformation setting, raster properties and configure georeferencer. The same options also we can get here. The first one, that is the open raster, start georeferencing script, load GCP points, save GCP, transformation setting, add point, delete point, move point, pan, zoom in, zoom out, zoom to layer and likewise next. Now here what we have to do, we have to add that previous topo sheet. Means which topo sheet? The topo sheet which we are going to do georeference, that topo sheet we have to open here. Okay, now go here, 1 minute. We can use this button also, and we can go here also, open raster. Both options are same one only, either we can directly use here or go to file, the same one only. I am here opening the topo sheet. Now don't be confused. When we start georeferencing, that time in main window we had opened that topo sheet. That is not any sense with this topo sheet. Okay, these are two same topo sheet, but we have to open here. That is not relation to any things we had opened there. See, topo sheet is here, we can remove also. There is no any required here. Okay, we'll just open our this topo sheet, will work here. Okay, now we are ready with the topo sheet. Okay, it's clear. Now what we have to do, now this is the just like a plain paper here. Okay, the meaning of this one, it is just a plain paper, nothing is there, because this is not georeference. Now we have to give the georeference. For that, what we have to do, we have to give the GCP. What is that GCP? Ground control point. Now those who are from geography background, already they handled topo sheet, they knows what is topo sheet, how we are reading the topo sheet, what things are there on the topo sheet. Okay, many things are there on the topo sheet. But those who are not from the geography background might be first time they are seeing this one. I'm just trying to zoom out, it is taking some time. Pan. Okay. Now I am just sharing this information, our participant, those not belongs to geography background. Okay, now this is the topo sheet. Okay, in the topo sheet we'll see there north, latitude, longitude, then their legend, everything is there. Okay, likewise their extension also there. See, latitude and longitude. Okay, now here these are the information. It is giving the information about their exact location. What is the latitude and longitude? Latitude and longitude are the imaginary lines on the earth surface. With the help of that lines, we are able to locate our location. Okay, now here we have to give the GCP. What is that GCP? GCP means ground control points. Okay, now here this one add point, that option is there, add point. Go to there, click here and just left click there on our, by using our mouse, just do the left click. Okay, when you will click there, left click, that time new window will appear there. Now we have to enter that things, latitude and longitude or x, y, y. Now here in the x we have to give this one 73.49. there are different methods also to enter this latitude and longitude. This is the in degree minute second, means this is the degree, here is the minute, and sometime suppose we made extra fraction, then we'll categorize into second also, degree minute second. We can convert that degree decimal also. There is some another method. See here, degree minute second, degree decimal, and projected coordinate in meter also. Now we are keeping as a degree minute or second, degree minute and second in that format. Suppose we have to do in degree decimal, then we have to change this value. Okay, there is small formula, according to that formula we can change that one also. Okay, now some people may get confused, how x this value and y this value. For this one we have to, because this is not a small concept, there is a very big theory. We have to go with all the theories. For that we will conduct another one session. Here first we will focus how to do georeferencing in the QGIS on the topo sheet. First we will complete that part, and suppose you require, next time again we will conduct another one session, particularly on theoretical part of that things. Okay, you just drop me message on WhatsApp or YouTube channel or mail, what kind of lectures do you require. Okay, now here for the x we have to give this one 73 degree 49 minute. Now here y 18:28, just okay. Now see, now you are able to see one red dot here, GCP, ground control point, means what is that? Now we mention here these points, means actual on the earth, that point is there, this point is reference with that point on the earth surface. The same way we have to give the all other points. Suppose you are not familiar with this thing, then you can write on paper also this thing, and then afterwards you can enter this one. Okay, on the maximum zoom, sorry, maximum zoom level, add point, left click of the mouse, then we have to enter the things, 73.52 and 18.28. okay, same thing we have to follow here, 73.52, 18.25. Okay, just do okay. Now we are ready with the Okay, now we are ready with the GCP, ground control points. Okay, see here 1, 2, 3, 4. We gave 4 GCPs. Okay, when we are giving that GCP there, that time it will appear here. See 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3. This is giving the ID. It is starting from the automatically 0, means we gave the 4 GCPs. Okay. Suppose we want to delete GCP, we can delete that GCP also. Just click here and click on that point, you can delete that one. One important thing is that here when we are giving that 4 GCPs, it doesn't mean that anywhere we can give that GCP. It's not like that. We have to maintain a particular sequence and that all point GCPs are equally distributed throughout our image, on map or topo sheet. Okay, equally distributed. Now see 1, 2, 3, 4, these 4 are equally distributed throughout the image. The way we gave the 4 points, same way we can increase the other points also. Means it doesn't mean that only 4 points are sufficient. The way you are increasing the number of GCPs, obviously you will get the more accuracy. Okay, for here, for learning purposes, we gave the 4 points. Now suppose you have to add 2 more, then what you will do? Suppose you have to give the 6 GCPs, then what we'll do? We'll give the, okay, we'll give the 2 extra, then where we can keep here, here, or here, here, or here, here, equally distributed. Suppose you have to add 4 GCPs extra, means total 8, then what we'll do? Already 4 are here, 1, 2, 3, 4, then we can give here 5th, 6, 7 and 8, like that, or 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, 1 here, equally distributed, like that. Okay, now we are ready with the GCP. Then we have to go here, transformation setting. Either we can go by here or in the setting here, both things are same only. Now here there are different options, transformation type, polynomial one. There are different types of also. Now this is again theoretical part, you read that theoretical part. Okay, resampling method, nearest neighbor and target, SRS. Here we have to give the our coordinate system. Okay, now here again we have to give the projected coordinate system. Why we have to give that projected coordinate system? Already I explained everything in previous lecture and in on our channel, that Telegram channel, already I have sent you all some materials regarding these points. Please you go through that point article. It is very nice article and very nicely explained geographic coordinate system and projected coordinate system. What is difference in that and why we have to use that particular coordinate system. Everything explained very nicely. Please go through that. After that also, suppose you have some doubt, then I'm always available. Okay, now projected coordinate system I have chosen here. Then output raster, what things we have to give here? We have to give the output path, means where we have to save our work. Then here is the browsing button, option are there. Now where I am going to save? I am going to save my work in workshop practice. Okay, in this folder everything I have saved. Save. Okay, then save GCP. Here suppose you want to save your GCP, you can save your GCP. Suppose you do not want to save your GCP, you just uncheck. But suppose I would recommend, suppose you are working very important project, you are doing your MPhil, PhD or any other thing which are very precious thing, then always keep all your material, all your work be saved. Then in that case you can save your GCP. Okay, the another thing is that generate PDF format, you can generate report also, you can generate here. Okay, then do the okay. Okay, when you will click on the okay, that time that process will complete. Then afterwards what we have to do? We have to go with here, start georeferencing. We can go by there also, or here is also start georeferencing option is there. Just we have to click over there. Okay, that process will continue. Okay, Now here georeference successfully, raster was successfully georeference. Okay, that message is here, means all process what we did, that is correct only. Go here down, transform polynomial, one mean error 0.3, that error it should be less than 0.5, then our whatever work we have done, that is correct. Okay, 0.3 means less than 0.5, it is acceptable. Then just minimize it and come to here. See, just compare with our previous topo sheet and this topo sheet. Whatever our previous topo sheet, that time that was just simple paper and there was no any coordinate system, projected system, nothing was there. Now when we gave the our projection and our GCPs, everything, then now see, whenever I am moving my cursor here, just look at here, just concentrate here on this figure. See, that figures are changing. What does it mean? Just I will show you what is exactly mean of that. See, this is our, now again I will tell. So you should know what is the latitude, longitude, how they are working and what is their functioning, then you can understand this thing. Otherwise you just message me. Suppose you have any doubt on that, we'll discuss later. Now see, my point is here, you just look at that figure downside, you just look at here. See, my hand is here, now it is showing 73.49. okay, now look at here, 73.49. now downside 1828. Whatever information we have given here, everything is correct, means the way we are moving our hand, wherever our hand is there, that information is showing on the coordinate. Okay, everything is there. Now our topo sheet is ready with the georeference, and you look at here, this is black border. What is mean? Means whatever earlier is that, it has just tilt, it is adjusted with the regarding our georeference and coordinate system. The meaning is that this is our topic, georeference. Now our topo sheet is ready with the georeferencing, and whatever work we have to do, we have to do on this georeference topo sheet. Afterwards we can do mosaicing. With the mosaic we can generate our big study area, we can cut, we can again attach another 2-3 topo sheet, we can generate our study area also. That all things are the after the georeferencing, means now you are ready to do our work. I hope you have understood how to do georeferencing. This is very important topic which we have covered today. Now suppose you have any doubt, please feel free to ask me. I am always available for your doubt. I will stop here. Again, we'll discuss on channel also or other platform also. Okay, thank you, and very sincerely apologize for the morning. I was trying to reach to you through live session, but because of technical error I was not able to do same. Now for that I have, in the afternoon I recorded this video and sending by YouTube and our channel. Thank you, good day.